breaking news on KGW News at 11.
Thanks for being with us. We have word now on two shootings in our area in the past 90 minutes. You're taking a live look right now from the first one in Northeast Portland. It happened on Fremont, just west of MLK. We know one person was taken to the hospital. We don't know how seriously they're hurt. Police have fanned out around that area. They're trying to find the shooter. At this point, no suspect description has been given to us to pass along to you. We'll let you know. And this is the scene now in Hillsboro, where another person was shot and killed in the parking lot of the Quatama Max Station. Thanks to Mark for this shot right here. You can see out of his window. In this case, police have the shooter in custody. Investigators say there's no danger to the public. The Blue Max line is being impacted by this, though. Riders are being bussed around the stop. Keep an eye out on KGW.com and the KGW app for updates on this breaking news.
Now at 11, stranded amid the rising tide on a Washington beach, hikers wave for help.
My hands are burned, so I can't use my phone.
Americans trapped in the volcanic eruption in New Zealand reach out to family. And an Oregon teen busted for trying to ride a wild buck. And super fans get in line for the first whiff of that double-double. But first,
somebody can see bubbles coming up and just a hand above.
A chance to save a life during a Portland holiday tradition.
It was a rescue that happened on the Willamette River last night near the Steel Bridge. More than a dozen boats decorated in Christmas lights just happened to pass by at the time and spot a man who was seconds away from drowning. As Catherine Cook shows us, they didn't let that happen.
The people who run the Portland Christmas Ships Parade love making people smile and bringing them joy. They never imagined they'd end up saving someone's life.
Every December, the Portland Christmas ships bring a bit of magic to the water. Cabins turn to dragons, skiffs into gifts, all twinkling and delighting with purpose.
This brightens people's day.
Christmas ships president Rob Steffick was piloting his boat, the Off the Clock, Tuesday night, leading a parade of 15 Christmas ships along the Willamette.
We're very safety conscious. We're always looking for things in the water.
So when Rob saw what he thought was a log in the river, he slowed down. Then realized.
Well, he said, help me.
It was a person in distress.
Water temperature is 42 degrees, so the person was definitely hypothermic.
Rob stopped the parade and turned his boat around.
The person started going under, so they were probably under for about 30 seconds. I mean, you could see bubbles coming up and just a hand above.
They used a boat hook to bring the man above water, then hoisted him on board.
We covered him up with a wool blanket that we had and just tried to take off because he was fully dressed and tried to start warming him up before Portland Fire and Rescue came. And they came very quickly.
Sheriff's deputies say the victim had tried to take his own life. Medics transported him to OHSU.
And I'm just glad we were in the right place at the right time because December at night in the Willamette, not a lot of boats going down the river.
Let alone a fleet of angels in Southwest Portland.
Makes you feel really good.
Catherine Cook, KGW News.
So the Cascades are about to get hammered with snow. Matt Cifino's got a look at the pass conditions right now and a look ahead, Matt.
Yeah, Dan, this is Sania Pass. You can see the snow is flying there. It's lightened up a little bit on Mount Hood at the moment, but down at Willamette Pass, snow coming down pretty hard as well. Now in the valleys, we've got a break from the rain as the cold front has moved on through. And in fact, I actually saw the moon, full moon through the clouds there just a bit ago. You can see on Doppler radar, it's broken up here. But the Cascades, it's going to be pretty solid. They've already picked up about 3 to 4 inches of new snow on Mount Hood at the skiest timberline of Mount Hood Meadows. So that's certainly good news there. And for the valleys, again, we are seeing a little bit of a break, but there'll be more rain that comes our way tomorrow. We have a winter storm warning up for the entire run of the Oregon Cascades from, down around Crater Lake, clear up to the Canadian border, basically. Also a high surf advisory on the coast. More on that coming up just a bit later on. But this is for heavy snowfall. We're talking at least a couple of feet up on Mount Hood. So here's the forecast for you. 15 to 30 inches above 4,500 feet, which is great because most of the passes, the government camp pass is below that elevation, so it won't get bad there until tomorrow night and into Friday morning. The heaviest snowfall will be during the day tomorrow, and then snow showers on Friday and some weekend sun breaks. So again, lots of snow coming to the Cascades. Certainly good news there. We've got other weather to talk about as well. The strong winds that are reaching the coast and the valley right now, and even a couple of thunderstorms. Back to you.
All right, talk to you again soon, Matt. Thank you. New tonight, we've been telling you guys at home about this Christmas tree shortage we've been dealing with this year, and it seems like some thieves maybe have been listening to the news because they're trying to take advantage of it. For the second time now in as many weeks a Christmas tree lot has been burglarized. Early yesterday morning, thieves took off with a trailer full of 70 trees from a lot on Northeast Sandy and 131st. Daryl Prowitt has been running that lot for 33 years. He knows it inside and out. He's said he does what he can to try and prevent stuff like this. He actually sleeps in a trailer on the lot. He had parked some cars in front of the specific trailer that was stolen, but that didn't seem to work. He has a good attitude, though at this point he's hoping to just break even this year.
I do want to continue doing it because it's not really about the money. It's about the trees and the people that they can gather their family around the tree and get together, you know, and it's not about the tree or the physical things. It's about what you do together that counts.
Yeah, you got it, man. 2 weeks ago, thieves, you may remember, took off with 90 trees from a lot run by a Gresham nonprofit. Daryl says that you can help. You can do your part. Stop this sort of thing from happening. If someone tries to sell you a tree for a deep discount, you should be suspicious. Daryl says the average tree right now is going for anywhere between $80 to $100. So at least 7 Portland bars have been hit by armed robbers in the last month. We started seeing some separate reports of these robberies popping up, and we just wanted to figure out, you know, how many businesses had been hit and if these crimes were possibly connected. We have a map here. It shows you all the robberies we've confirmed so far from Southeast to North Portland. They include Mulligan's, Tulip Shop Tavern, Cosmo Lounge, Wilshire Tavern, Lombard Pub, Mock Crest Tavern, and Darcy's Restaurant, twice actually. The thieves all have a similar MO. They were armed, they wore masks, they went straight for the cash. The bars were targeted late at night, and most of them had video lottery machines.
I've talked to a couple other bar owners, not just in this neighborhood, but across town, and everybody's worried about it because, I mean, it's just like a couple summers ago. Whoever's doing this seems to just be running all over the town. It doesn't seem like there's any particular rhyme or reason to the places that they're picking.
You know, that's the owner right there of Lombard Pub. Imagine being there, being a patron or working there. He says that there were 20 people actually inside his bar around 11:15 on November 30th, and that's when two robbers, they barged in, held the bartender at gunpoint, and took off with hundreds of dollars in cash. So far, police say they haven't been able to make any connections really between these cases, and they haven't arrested any suspects. There may be more robberies that we don't know about yet, too. We're trying to figure that out. If you know of one that we didn't mention, email us at newstips@kgw.com. We're trying to connect these dots here. You can also submit a tip to our website or just find us on Facebook. All right, looking ahead to tomorrow now, we're going to see the grand opening of that In-N-Out Burger in Kaiser. We have a live look for you right now from the restaurant tonight. We've talked to a few people who are starting to line up. Already, right? Spending the night out there in the rain outside of In-N-Out. They're staking out their spot. They want to grab their first double-double. I don't know if they're dressed warm enough. Look at that guy's got a t-shirt, I think, on the left. The restaurant opens at 9 a.m., so they got some time to wait. Officials expect about 200 cars in the drive-through lane during peak times. Imagine that? They plan to have people wait the Volcano Stadium parking lot as the drive-through backs up. We talked to one anxious customer tonight.
I'm always trying to be, you know, like I'm an explorer, like to be out here and see what the crowd is all about, especially for an In-N-Out Burger.
All right, we're going to be there tomorrow. We'll be there too. We're getting paid to do it though. I'm sure somebody will try and get a burger while they're working, one of the reporters. We'll let you know how the situation is. Earlier tonight, they did have a special preview for VIPs. State Representative Bill Post, he was one of them. He shared a picture of his first order on Twitter. All right, let's get you caught up on some of tonight's other headlines. An Oregon man has been arrested for riding a wild buck. He was trapped in an enclosure at the time. A lot of people upset about this. The 18-year-old was being filmed. This is a screenshot, a couple of them from that video. It appears to show him grabbing that exhausted deer by the antlers. This was in Harney County in eastern Washington. That suspect now faces charges for wildlife harassment and animal abuse. The deer eventually got free, but at this point we don't really know how it's doing. The Coast Guard came to the rescue of two hikers stranded on a Washington beach. You see the infrared camera here shows those two figures on the ground waving for help. They were stranded in Ledbetter State Park. That's on the Long Beach Peninsula. The tide had started to come around them and trap them. Basically, they were surrounded by water. The Coast Guard dropped down to hoist them up. The hikers were taken away in a chopper in a basket. It's a reminder to check the tide tables before you head out onto the beach. Police confirmed that the man they shot and killed in Southeast Portland over the weekend had a couple of knives on him. They released these pictures that you see here of the knives. They released these just tonight. The man killed was 51-year-old Coben Henriksen. We still don't know why officers decided to shoot him. We're going to keep pushing for that info, though. Two more people have died now following that volcanic eruption on Monday in New Zealand, on New Zealand's White Island. That brings the suspected total death count right now to 16. Many of those who survived the blast suffered horrific burns. NBC's Janice Mackey-Frayer is in New Zealand.
Tonight, a family devastated. Matthew Hollander, just 13, and his 16-year-old brother, Barrent, are the first Americans confirmed dead from the volcanic eruption here. Their parents, Martin and Barbara, still missing. It's unclear if they made it off the island.
We are now living with a growing sense of desperation to bring home those that we know are there.
But it's still too dangerous for rescue teams to reach there. Satellite images before and after the eruption show the crater smothered with ash. And tonight, a warning from authorities.
The situation remains highly volatile.
It could erupt again within 24 hours. Seven Australians are confirmed dead. Even identifying survivors has been a struggle. Their burns so extensive that skin needed for grafting has been ordered from the U.S. to treat them.
My mom, it's me. I just want to let you know, and this isn't a joke.
American Matthew Ure left a voicemail telling his mother that he and his wife, Lauren, needed surgery. Their conditions remain critical.
My hands are burned, so I can't use my phone.
The island sits on the Pacific Ring of Fire, and it's at its most active in years. Now, with a 40 to 60% chance of another eruption, the pressure inside the volcano is rising. Janice Mackey-Frayer, NBC News, Whakatane, New Zealand.